Okay, everybody, thank you for coming back. Right on time. We're going to continue with Mr. Abraham Assefa, who's the director of the Animal Biodiversity Directorate here at the Ethiopian Biodiversity Institute. And he'll be speaking about animal genetic resource diversity of Ethiopia, conservation efforts, threats, and challenges.
Okay, thank you very much. And thank you, the organizers, for the organizers and, okay. I thank you, the organizers, for giving me the chance to bring some issues about animal genetic resource to you. And my presentation is on animal biodiversity conservation efforts, threats and challenges in Ethiopia. Yeah. Okay, my presentation has the following outline. I'll say something about what animal biodiversity is, how we approach animal biodiversity in our research and the conservation activities, and we'll see, I'll see some purpose of keeping animals, why we keep animals, especially in the agrarian society. Roles of having diverse animal genetic resources, like in breeds, we refer on always when animal diversity, we refer breeds and species. Especially breed, we say wild animal, domestic animal breeds. When we say species, we refer aquatic and wild animal species. The other is we have a lot of diversity as well. We have major threats on animal diversity that affect the diversity in our country. The other is conservation efforts carried out so far. We have so many threats, so what we are going to do, what we have been doing to curb these threats. The other is stakeholders collaboration in conservation and the research. This is all the conservation and the research activities, what we have been doing is in collaboration with other stakeholders. So I want to say something about the stakeholders that we have been doing together. The other is challenges encountered. Okay, we have the big responsibility in the conservation and the research on animal biodiversity. But during this process, we have so many challenges. I will mention some points about those challenges. To start with, what animal biodiversity and what we say, what animals are, which includes all animal species, breeds and strains, which have economic as well as cultural and scientific values to man. We approach animal genetic resources into three categories. Can you hear me? Okay. Okay. We approach animal genetic resource in categorizing in three groups. The first is domestic or farm animal diversity. The other is wild animal as well as aquatic animal genetic resource. This is what we have been doing in conservation and research activities. Domestic animals are those animals domesticated and living with people to serve both economic as well as aesthetic values. The other is wild animal diversity, those animals which are undomesticated and which include mammals, herpetofauna, entomofauna, avifauna, and other aquatic animal genetic resources. So we approach those animal genetic or diversity into these three categories. When we say something about, the purpose of keeping animal diversity, we know that we have huge animal genetic resources in the country. We are mostly, we say, like first in Africa and 10th in the world. Just in livestock resources. When you come to individual species like cattle, we are sixth in the world. And we can come to donkeys, we are second in the world. So we have huge animal genetic resources in the country. These animal genetic resources have immense or multifaceted roles through all the food chains. Just to mention, at household level and at national level, At household level, animals are the source of food, especially quality protein, essential amino acids. They are the source of income generation. When we say food, for example, when you see the pastoralist to the mixed crop livestock system, animals support us. 60% of the food people depend on the pastoralist areas, whereas in the mixed crop livestock, it supports 40% of the food people eat. So they have many roles, and they have a role in income generation. And when you see the income generation, especially in the agriculture society, they support from 40 to 80% of income generated from the livestock we have. It is very high in the livestock, in the pastoral and agro-pastoral system, and it is low, relatively lower in the mixed crop livestock, where cropping is the major activity. And they have also they are important in transport and agriculture. They are the main role players in agriculture, especially crop agriculture for plowing and traction. The other is insurance and saving. They are also insurance against the failure of other activities like cropping, and they serve as a saving. When we calculate the amount of saving in livestock, IGAD calculated livestock generated $86 billion per year for saving, important as a banking system for the agriculture society. And they have social and cultural purposes, and they are also important in tourism. We can say for, especially when you see the protected area system, some national parks can supply around 6 million per year. So these protected areas are also, they have also ecosystem functions. To mention some, you can manage the PS. Ecosystem value is estimated as $1.5 billion per year. So this is the ecosystem services that the animals are providing. At national level, animals are important for food security as well as for poverty reduction activities. It is livestock provides 26% of the agricultural GDP to the total economy, and they are also a source of foreign exchange. Like sale of animal meat and hides and skin are very important in our economy. When we see the animal genetics, especially the livestock resources, still for when you see them, it is increasing for the last 6 to 7 years. Even though still the per capita consumption of meat and the milk is still very low, but the number of animals are still increasing. And this is also important in say, diversity. You can see that cattle genetic resource from 2006 up to 2014, there is an increasing of 12 million. So the same is true for all livestock species. So we have a huge resource of livestock as well. Its numbers are increasing. We'll see what the diversity seems like. To see some importance of livestock just in picture, this is camel giving milk, and the camel is also a source of transport and other food items. This is fish. This is the purpose of livestock for transportation. It helps for transporting input to the field and from products from the field to the household or to the village. This is one of the donkey breed, which we call Sinar. It's very important for transporting people as well as agriculture products. Animal biodiversity and its roles, especially we have seen huge resources, but not only the huge resource in number, but we are a center of diversity in livestock, and we have a lot of species, wildlife species, including endemic ones. Center of diversity for animal genetic resource. Why we are a center of diversity? We can mention many reasons. There is a high altitudinal or geographical difference. from the lowest dalol up to Ras Dishin. And we have diverse ecosystems and agroecosystems. In number, we have 10 ecosystems and 18 agroecosystems. That's as a result of this geographical difference. And we have different climatic situations like temperature, rainfall, and we are a gate for movement of domestic animals, especially for domestic animals. Ethiopia is just serves as a gateway of the movement of livestock from Asia to Africa, so that we are a center or melting point of this livestock breeds. The other is we have diverse aquatic ecosystems. The aquatic ecosystems have different physico-chemical properties that also serves for that having a diverse animal genetic resources in the country. So we have, we said the reasons that we have these diverse resources, but up to now it's not exhaustive, but the identification and the characterization results show that we have around 73 breeds of domestic animals. And we can mention like 28 breeds of cattle, 9 breeds of sheep, 8 breeds of goat, 7 breeds of camel, donkey, horse, and ecotypes of chicken and honeybee races and species. So we have all these resources. But when we say this, we are not exhaustive. Still, there is a characterization and identification carried on both by us as well as other stakeholders. Especially in some breeds. For example, we have said we have 28 breeds of cattle, but it is very, it's not exhaustive. This is done only on phenotypic characterization. We need to do a lot to identify. We can make it more than this. So we have to do a lot to identify them. The other is we have 7 breeds of or ecotypes of chickens, but still there is a characterization work. It's not exhaustive, just to mention some. The other is animal biodiversity is a species. We said a species is referring to wild animals as well as aquatic animal genetic resources. We have a lot of species in that, includes endemic species and migratory birds and important bird areas. We have 3 important bird areas in the country where these temperate birds can come and spend some time and go back to their original place. So up to now, we have identified 284 species of mammals. Among these, 36 is endemic. We have 926 avian species, 23 are endemic. We have 201 species of reptiles and 73 species of frogs and toads. We have also 1,225 species of insects. Among these, 29 are endemic. We have 200 species of fish, 40 are endemic. So we have a lot of diversity in case of wild as well as aquatic genetic diversity. And most of them are endemic. And still, we are not exhaustive in identifying of this species. Still, a lot of work has to be done to identify those species and to make it more comprehensive. Especially those points we can see in the reptiles, frogs and toads, and especially insects and entomofauna. We did a very, very little to identify the species. So we need to do a lot in order to identify those species. To show some of this diversities in breeds and species, this is a Nuer or Abigar cattle breed, which is found in Western Ethiopia, Gambella region. This is Arado breed, which is found in Tigray, in Northern Ethiopia. This is Borana breed, which is found in the south Ethiopia, Oromia region. This is where the south Ethiopia, especially the Borana area, is where this Boran breed is developed. and it is now improved in Kenya and Australia. So the source is this breed. It's our breed now. The other is the Afar cattle breed, which is found in the eastern part of Ethiopia. Very, very arid climatic situation. It produces and serves for food and other activities for the people. The other is Ogaden cattle breed in Ethiopian Somali region. Also, it's very important breed in that area. This is Manzi sheep breed, which is very important in the very highland area in Manz. This is Benishangul Gumz region, which is Gumz sheep breed, also very important in the western part of our country. This is Arsibale goat breed. Okay, most of the time we need, we say like goats are very important in the lowland areas, but we have goats which are important very highland and temperate area relatively in our country. This is Arsibale goats, which is found in the Bale Mountain area. This is long-eared Somali goat breed, which is very important in the very arid area of Somali, Ethiopian Somali region. These are some of the chicken ecotypes in our country. I said this characterization and identification of our chicken are still we are doing, but we are not exhaustive, but we have these different breeds. This is different bird species. To show some of the mammals and based on the altitudinal difference or ecosystem difference. From the highland, very highland Afro-Alpine ecosystem to the desert and the semi-desert scrubland ecosystem, we have different wild animal species. You can see here, wild ibex mostly is known as endangered breed. This is Ethiopian wolf, Canis simensis, also is categorized as endangered breed. Can you see this necked mole rat? This is very important laboratory animal in medical research in cardiovascular disease, Alzheimer's, and as well as cancer. This animal is found to be not affected by cancer. And it's very important for future research for aging. The normal rat can stay at, can mature at 2 years old, but this can stay up to 30 years. So people can use this animal for further research. And it's expected that people can live up to 600 years. So it's a very important animal, which is found in the desert and the semi-desert areas in the Somali area, in Babila and the Dereda areas. To say something about roles of having diverse animal breeds. Previously I said we have huge animal genetic resource and it serves for economy as well as social purpose. But what is the function of this diversity? We have different breeds and species. What service this diversity we have? It gives an opportunity to use different breeds and species for different ecology and agroecologies. We have different altitudinal differences and we have different climatic situations. So we have an opportunity to use these different breeds at different ecological situations. Like we can mention the roles of camel and the goat breeds in dry lowlands, the roles of different sheep breeds in wetter and high rainfall areas, the roles of trypano-tolerant cattle breed in the humid areas. We can mention like Shako is very resistant to trypanosomiasis disease. And there is an opportunity for further breeding and upgrading work in the face of climate change and market changes. So this is the purpose of diversity that we are utilizing. To show some of the important breeds for different purposes. For example, this is one of the cattle breed in our country, which is called, we call it Horro cattle breed, which is very important for meat purpose. This is Horro sheep breed in the same area. for meat purpose. This is a very important cattle breed in the rugged mountain of northern Ethiopia in Europe area. So this Europe cattle is important and feed itself in the mountainous areas to produce food and other purpose for the people. We have a lot of diversity, I said, but we have also major traits that decreases the diversity. We can mention major traits that affects animal diversity. We can categorize into two groups for domestic or farm animal genetic resource, as well as wild and aquatic genetic resource in terms of species. In terms of domestic or farm animal diversity or breeds, drought and disease is said to be the very important trait, especially in affecting born cattle breed. The effect of drought in animal in decreasing the diversity of animal genetic resource is not only the death of the animal, but the problem is when drought comes, many animals die, and then after the drought, there is a restocking program. In the restocking program, there is a very big dilution. So drought and the disease is one of the threats. The other is conflict. I have mentioned Europe cattle breed. This cattle breed is affected by conflict by Ethiopia and Eritrea. This Europe cattle breed is in the border of Ethiopia and Eritrea. So conflict is one reason. The other is increasing inbreeding. Due to production system change, the number of animals kept by a household is decreasing. So homogeneous genes increases. That is deleterious also. And it affects the fertility rate and other in domestic animal breeds. So this is one effect. The other is change in production system, which affecting Sheko and the Fogara cattle breed in our country. This change in production system, we can mention, like previously it was a very extended area of grazing land, but now due to agricultural encroachment into the grazing land, now people are wanted to decrease the number. So due to this reason, Sheko and the Fogara cattle are really decreasing breeds. So we consider them as threatened. The other threat is uncontrolled crossbreeding. This uncontrolled crossbreeding is mean the objective is to improve productivity. But if it is not controlled, that is the cause of dilution of this diverse indigenous genetic resource. This is very serious in our country, relatively in chicken genetic resource, but it is the case in cattle also, but very serious in chicken diversity. To mention some of the traits in wild animal genetic resource, habitat conversion is the first one. The other is natural water pollution, especially on water animals. Conflict and the illegal hunting, very major effect in wild animals as well as the PA system in our country. Invasive species, it affects both the water and the terrestrial environment, climate change and over-harvesting, especially on genetic fish genetic resources are the major threats in our country. To mention the level of threats in animal genetic resource, for example, we have mentioned, we have up to now 926 species of birds. Among these, 19 species of birds are threatened, categorized under different threat level, endangered, critically endangered, and so on by IUCN. We can mention like example, Sidamo lark, which is distributed in Nagele Borona area in the southern Ethiopia region, which is restricted from through 30 to 36 kilometers square grassland area. So this is a threatened one. The other bird species which is threatened is Princeps polytrachos, which is threatened due to habitat degradation and hybridization with white-cheeked turaco, other species. The other is, we have also mentioned, we have 284 species of mammals. Among these, which is 38 species of mammals are categorized under endangered species under different threat level. Ethiopian wolf and the one-eyed ibex are the commonest one, which is, for example, Ethiopian wolf is in danger in 2008 and also in 2014. It is categorized at in danger level in both these years. The major threat is rabies, especially in the Bali Mountain National Park, which is this species is found mostly. And then the major threat is rabies that causes damage. The other is wild ibex. This also is mentioned for many years as a threatened breed, but now these days, due to very huge conservation efforts is being made by UCA and other stakeholders, its number is increasing, but it is still mentioned as endangered breed by IUCN in 2008. Other species to mention, for example, this frog and the toad species, which is Ethiopian mountain toad, Ethiopian banana frog, and the Susan's tree frog, all are categorized under different threat levels, which are found in Bali Mountain and in Gugge Mountain area. To mention some of the threat level in aquatic genetic resource, for example, this species, Labiobarbus gorgori, which is locally threatened in Lake Tana, and the Labiobarbus topicus, which is also locally threatened in Maki River, just to mention some. To mention some threatened domestic animals, I have mentioned, mostly mentioned are Fogara breed and that of Shako breed from the cattle, and the other one is Europe cattle breed, which are very threatened and their number is decreasing. What are the conservation efforts carried out so far? Just to mention some. In domestic animals, we have been doing in characterization, especially socioeconomic and the production system survey. We propose and are working on community-based conservation and the improvement program and awareness raising program. Based on these activities, up to now, we have been working on conserving 9 breeds at different regions of the country. Concerning the wild animal genetic resources, we employ ecosystem-based conservation approach. We do what identification, the ecosystem and its genetic resource diversity, conservation and the sustainable utilization. We develop, based on the identification and the research carried out, we develop the guideline for advising people to use that guideline and to conserve the genetic resource. Awareness raising is another activity. Recently, we are employing, like ecosystem-based conservation, we are employing selecting the umbrella or flagship species in a certain ecosystem, so that conserving that flagship species is meant conserving the ecosystem. We are following this approach also. Based on this approach, we are conserving 6 ecosystem-based approaches being implemented at different parts of the country. The other in-situ conservation activity, as I mentioned before, is a protected area system. We have 92 protected area systems in our country, which are administered by different stakeholders in our country, especially PAs are administered by EUCA, Ethiopian Wildlife Conservation Authority, and we have also 4 biosphere reserves. This is also considered as in-situ conservation. Money in the biosphere, just its slogan is just people and animals or wildlife can live together. So this we have 4 biosphere reserves, which is administered by Minister of Science and Technology. In total, protected area system in the country covers 14% of the country, the land area. So we have these resources. Concerning conservation activities, in the country we have different tranches for conservation and the sustainable utilization of different breeds, domestic animal breeds. Like we have 5 tranches to conserve Borana, Fogara, Arsibale, Begaite, and the Horro cattle breeds. The principle of ranching is simply conservation, research, and development. Selecting a certain, creating a nucleus flock, and then selecting a best animal, distributing them into the community, then affecting positively for the whole breed. That is conservation as well as development. The other is cryopreservation. We are employing semen collection and freezing, but we need to work a lot on cryopreservation. We need to work on embryo and others in the future. The other is using zoo and the captive breeding system. Actually, this zoo and the captive breeding system is a type of conservation, but for highly threatened species, and increasing the number, and that species should come back to the natural ecosystem. This also is employed by different stakeholders. As I said before, we are not working alone. We are working this characterization as well as conservation activities with different stakeholders in the country. Just to mention some regional biodiversity units, in we are working in collaboration to identification and the characterization. Universities, we have so many universities. Most of them, agriculture universities, are carrying out these characterization activities. Our mandate is to filter, to list those characterization activities, so they are working with us. The national agricultural system, national agricultural, national artificial insemination center, we are working together in cryopreservation. IUCA, wildlife conservation and research, we are working together. ILRI and the FAO, International Livestock Research Institute, and the FAO, we are working together on conservation, research, and reporting, especially with FAO, identifying the breeds and cataloging and creating databases. Okay, we have a lot of responsibilities to study, to catalog, to characterize all animal genetic resources in the country. We have a lot of diversity. But with this responsibility, to carry out this all responsibility, we have so many challenges. One of the challenges is lack of required human skill and knowledge in taxonomic identification, genetic characterization, as well as exit conservation beyond conserving semen, like conserving DNA, embryo, and others. This is one problematic area. The other, lack of equipped laboratories to carry out in-depth research and conservation. We don't have that one. The other is lack of adequate budget that commensurate with huge animal diversity we have. So we have a lot of mandate. We have a lot of things to do. But the budget we have is very, very small. That are some of the challenges encountered in conservation and the sustainable utilization of animal genetic resource in our institute. So thank you very much.